Hello friends, myself S.M.Math, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am explaining regarding the how to calculate the length of belt in the cross belt drive. The basic learning outcome from this video is at the end of this session, student will able to calculate the length of cross belt drive. Pause the video, see the triangle and calculate the value of sine x and cos x. Now the answers are here. Sine x is equal to this opposite side upon hypotenuse and cos x is equal to adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Here I am showing the diagram and with continuation with explaining the how to calculate the derivation of the cross belt drive. Here the two pulleys are there. One is O1 pulley, that is a driver. Second is a O2 pulley, that is a driven one. And this is a continuous belt from A to B, B to F, F to C, C to D, D to E and E to A again. So now today we have to calculate the length of this belt. So basically R1 is a radius for the driver pulley and R2 is a radius for the driven pulley. Now belt come in contact, that is A to E, E to D, and belt come in contact, we can contact with the smaller pulley C to F, F to B. So and the belt not in contact with the pulley, that is AB and CD. Okay. Now R1 is a radius of larger pulley and R2 is a radius of this smaller pulley. And C is the distance between the two pulleys. C is the distance between these two pulleys. Now, length L is equal to, total length you have to calculate, L is equal to arc AED. It is arc AED. Length L is equal to arc AED plus AED plus length DC, length DC plus arc CFB, arc CFB, arc CFB and length belt BA. Length BA. Now this CD and AB are equal. AB is equal to CD. That is a, you have to taking a two times. And here arc AED means it is a arc ED. That is a two times of arc. Arc AE is equal to arc ED. So you have to taking it as arc two times. So length L is equal to 2 times into bracket ED, arc ED plus AB is equal to CD. So AB and CD taking as one of them, length AB plus arc CFB means 2 times of arc BF, 2 times of arc BF. Okay. Now, what is the value of arc ED and arc BF? Arc ED means it is a pi by 2 plus alpha, because belt in come in contact with this angle is angle DO1D. So D dash O, angle D dash O1D is equal to alpha, is equal to angle बी डैश ओ टू बी और बी ओ टू बी डैश इज अल्फा इज इक्वल टू अल्फा. ठीक है, सो इट इज अ टोटल इज पाई डी, सो पाई बाय टू प्लस अल्फा. सो लेंथ एल इज इक्वल टू टू टाइम्स इंटू ब्रैकेट, टू टाइम्स इंटू ब्रैकेट पाई बाय टू प्लस अल्फा, पाई बाय टू प्लस अल्फा, इट इज अ पाई बाय टू प्लस अल्फा इंटू आर वन, रेडियस ऑफ आर वन, आर वन प्लस लेंथ ए बी प्लस अगेन हियर बी एफ मीन्स पाई बाय टू प्लस अल्फा इंटू आर टू, पाई बाय टू प्लस अल्फा इंटू आर टू, ब्रैकेट कंप्लीट. सो मल्टीप्लाइंग दिस वन इज इक्वल टू टू टाइम्स रीज कैंसल्ड पाई आर वन प्लस टू अल्फा आर वन प्लस लेंथ ए बी प्लस दिस टू गेट कैंसल्ड हियर दैट इज पाई आर टू प्लस टू अल्फा आर टू. ठीक है, सो दिट इज अ टोटल लेंथ, ब्रैकेट कंप्लीट. नाउ यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द लेंथ ए बी. हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द लेंथ ए बी, दिस लेंथ ए बी इज इक्वल टू लेंथ सी डी, इट इज गिवन हियर. नाउ दिस एंगल अल्फा, यू ड्रॉ वन मोर लाइन सी डी पैरेलल वन लाइन फ्रॉम ओ टू टू द सी डी इट एंड यू हैव टू एक्सटेंड दिस लाइन, नेम इट एज अ जी. सो इट इज अ 90 डिग्री, दिस इज ऑल्सो 90 डिग्री. So these two lines are parallel to each other. So this angle is alpha. So cos alpha is equal to, because we have to calculate the length CD. So cos alpha is equal to O2G divided by C. C means the distance between the two pulleys. That is O2G. Divided by C, and this O2G is a parallel to CD. So here AB is equal to CD is equal to O2G. So here you have to write is equal to, instead of O2G you have to write AB, that is C. So therefore AB is equal to C cos alpha. So AB is equal to C into cos alpha. AB is equal to C cos alpha. Name it as 1. ठीक है, so put this value here. So length L is equal to pi R1 plus 2 alpha R1 plus C cos alpha. These are all are 2 times. Huh? So 2 times C cos alpha. Sorry, not 2 times. Pi R1 2 alpha R1 plus C cos alpha plus pi R2 plus 2 alpha R2, bracket complete. Now length L is equal to this pi R1 and this pi R2 common, pi into bracket R1 plus R2 plus this 2 alpha R1 into this 2 alpha R2, so 2 alpha into bracket R1 plus R2 plus C cos alpha. So C cos alpha. So here this is the formula to calculate the total length of the belt. Name it is formula 21. Length L is equal to pi into bracket R1 plus R2 plus 2 alpha into bracket R1 plus R2 plus C cos alpha. But here some values we have to calculate it, that is value of cos alpha and value of alpha, because you know that sine alpha is equal to alpha when the values are very less, means which values the radius are very small and the distance between the two shafts are big one. So you have to calculate the exact length of that belt in the next section with calculating of value of alpha, cos alpha and sine alpha.